Right, we're going to talk about numbers in the news because just recently the number 17 was in the news. This is one for Sudoku fans because it's just been recently proved by a man called Gary Maguire. He's a mathematician at University College in Dublin, has proven that a Sudoku needs at least 17 clues to solve it. So Sudoku, if you don't know what they are, they come from Japan. They were big in the 1980s, but then so were many things. But here is a Sudoku. It's a 9x9 grid, and the idea is you fill every row with the numbers 1 to 9 without repeats. You fill every column with the numbers 1 to 9 without repeats, and then add for extra difficulty, you fill these little squares, these 3x3 squares, with the numbers 1 to 9 without repeat. And the idea with Sudoku is they'll give you some clues. They'll clear most of this away. It'll look like something like this. They'll give you some clues and they'll ask you to complete the Sudoku grid. And the idea is there should only be one way to complete the Sudoku grid. If you see them in the newspapers give you about 25 clues to solve the grid. But what Sudoku fans were interested in was, what is the fewest number of clues that you need to solve that grid? And the Sudoku fans tried to find the fewest numbers you needed. They found puzzles that had 17 numbers, but they couldn't find any puzzles with 16 numbers. If you tried to find puzzles with 16 numbers, the answer you got wasn't unique. You could get one or two answers from that puzzle. So they thought maybe 17 is the smallest number you needed. And so just at the beginning of this month, this was proved by Gary Maguire, who did a method which was partly mathematics and partly using computer power. Let's talk about how many Sudokus there are. Right, if I want to fill a Sudoku grid like this, the number of possible Sudoku grids is, let me write this down for you, let's see, number of grids. Let's put an S on the end of that. Number of Sudoku grids is, well, in words, it's 6,700 million, million, million. Mathematicians write it like this, 6.7 times 10 to the 21. So this is the number of Sudoku grids that there are. Now, importantly, what they were saying is, they're not saying that every Sudoku grid can be solved with 17 clues. They are saying that there are no Sudoku grids that can be solved with 16 or fewer clues. Not uniquely anyway. So one way to solve this puzzle is to take all the possible Sudoku grids and check all of them for 16 clue starting positions and to check if they give you a unique answer. That's one way to do it. It's a brute force way to do it. How many ways are there to pick 16 clues from my Sudoku grid? That number, 16 clues, I can't spell, 16 clues is around about 33 million billion, around about 33 times 10 to the 16. I think I've got that, 3.3 times 10 to the 16. Now, this is a massive number. The problem was, the guy who worked this out, Gary Maguire, if he estimated that if he used the method that he already had, it would take a computer around about 300,000 years to check every possible Sudoku grid for every possible 16 clue starting position. So he had to make the problem more simple than that. This is what he did. You see, Sudokus, what you can do is if I took the first two rows and swapped them over, it would still be a valid Sudoku grid. That's allowed, right? It's the same. If I took any of those first three rows and swapped them over, you would get a valid Sudoku grid. The same is true for the next three rows. If you swap them over, you'd get a valid grid. And the last three rows, you swap them over, you get a valid grid. And these bands as well. If you take these as bands and swapped the bands over, you get a valid grid. So if you had a valid 16 clue starting position, it would still be a valid 16 clue starting position when you start to swap the rows. What you get is a whole family of Sudokus. It's the same for the columns. It's the same if I rotate the grid. And it's the same if I start to swap the numbers. If I took all the threes and swapped them with all the fives, you still get a valid grid. You get a whole family. So all you need is one representative from each family of Sudoku grids. Now, how many of those are there? But all they need to do is check one representative from each family. Now, they could also reduce the number of 16 clues that they had to check, this number. What you can do, here's my Sudoku grid again. Take a look at this. You see this 7 and 9? And down here, I've got another 7 and 9 in the same columns. Now, if I swap the 7s and 9s over, I get another valid Sudoku grid. Now, I don't want to get two possible answers from my Sudoku puzzle. So if I want a unique solution, one of my clues has to be one of these four numbers. These are unavoidable squares. So at least one of your clues has to be from those squares. So if you can find the unavoidable squares, that reduces the number of 16 clues you have to check. That's what they did. So they were looking for unavoidable squares, checking for these representatives from families of Sudoku grid. Then they started to, by brute force with a computer, analyze them. It took them 7 million computer hours to do it. They started in January 2011. They finished the project in December 2011, and they proved that nothing they checked, you couldn't get a 16 clue puzzle from all these Sudoku grids. We know 17 clue puzzles exist, so therefore they proved it. 17 is the smallest amount of squares, it's the fewest clues you need to solve a Sudoku grid, uniquely, and that's the most important part.
Scientists and mathematicians get asked this all the time, but if there's ever an appropriate time to ask this, this seems like it. Surely there are better things to do with your time.
Yeah, right. Completely understand. Well, for a start, we're talking about it because it's a bit of fun, right? And people know what Sudoku are, so they can understand the puzzle that I'm trying to solve here, the problem. By doing this, it's a hard problem. It's a hard problem. The methods that they had to develop to solve this problem can be used in other, perhaps more serious applications, in other problems in mathematics, in other problems in combinatorics. And so it's, although it seems like it's a trivial thing, it actually pushes the boundaries of our knowledge. So it turns out not to be so. Do you want to hear my Gary Maguire joke?
Go on.
So this is my Gary Maguire joke. Gary Maguire is the guy who solved this puzzle. Right, here's my Gary Maguire joke. What did the Sudoku say to Gary Maguire? You complete me. That's a reference to the film Jerry Maguire.
Yeah.
It's like a joke.
Yeah.
It's not much like one, I'll give you that. I have to be honest, Sudoku for me are not my favourite type of puzzles because it is a game of pure logic. Now, people think mathematicians are just, you know, logic machines, like we're robots. But that isn't what mathematics is about. I'm very keen to stress that this isn't what mathematics is about. It's a much more creative thing than that. And so for me, because this is a game of pure logic that I know a computer can do, I have no interest in it. But this is very popular with people. Crosswords enthusiasts and Sudoku enthusiasts, these are very popular kind of puzzles.